The ONE Championship roster is filled with the best fighters to come out of Indonesia. And it's only a matter of time before Indonesia has its first ONE World Champion. On the 6th of November, two Indonesian athletes continue their climb to the top. Indonesian wrestling champion Eko Roni Saputra makes a quick turnaround to face Ramon Gonzalez. And Wushu World Championship medalist Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol faces the toughest test of her career, second-ranked atomweight contender Meng Bo. Tati has been a steady force in ONE Championship, most recently beating two-time Myanmar national boxing champion Bozhena Antoniyar.
Wushu Sanda versus boxing. Antoniyar comes in back-to-back wins, including a career-high decision win over Bing Nguyen. Priscilla comes in 3-2 in her last five. Hasn't finished an opponent since May 2018, when she subbed Rome Trinidad with a guillotine. Looking for the inside leg is Antoniyar.
See Toto trying to paw down the hand of Priscilla.
Far, we do have two very similar nicknames. Toto is, of course, Bozhena Antoniyar, and Tati is Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. Inside leg kick from Antoniyar, then fires up here, rapid hands. Left kick from Antoniyar, roundhouse kick to the ribs from the little lady from Myanmar that packs a lot of power. Left hook from Antoniyar. Tries the overhand right, back to center circle. Priscilla, two submissions, one knockout, six wins. Two knockouts and three wins for Bozhena Antoniyar.
Beautiful push kick, but then she threw a follow-up roundhouse kick that caught Toto on the side of her head, and it looks like it gave her a welt.
Oh, there's damage on the forehead of Bozhena Antoniyar. Let's have a look at what happened here, folks.
She caught her again with a beautiful side kick. She caught it once, caught her twice, sat her down with the second one. But then, right as Toto was getting up, you can see the roundhouse kick follows. The hand is still down. Hand is still down. Boom. Shin to forehead. Backs her up again. It looks like Toto is okay to continue, but I think they just want to make sure an athlete's safety is our number one priority. We want to make sure everything is okay with Toto and she's good to continue.
Officials are assessing the situation here. As referee Omeki heads over to Priscilla, reaches into his pocket, and he's going to yellow card her. Tell us about what happened with the yellow card, Brandon.
The yellow card is an automatic 10% first deduction from the athlete who receives yellow card. Now, if the match is very close, possible, it can reflect the judge's scoring.
Now, referee Omeki has called for the ringside physician to look over the forehead of Bozhena Antoniyar.
Yeah, they might want to get an end swell on that because she is developing a serious mouse on her forehead. And it's pretty close to the eye, so that the hand is, can't really quite see it there, but the hand.
Okay.
Ooh, that's close.
Was she grounded, maybe?
I don't know, she might have had her hand up.
I don't know if she was grounded. Wow, we're gonna recommence here. Go!
Either way, run away.
Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol has the reach, has the height over Bozhena Antoniyar. Antoniyar has the power, has the speed in the hand. There is a hematoma over the left arm of Bozhena Antoniyar. Chance go up for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. Priscilla, who is a very quiet child, did ballet, enjoyed playing with dolls, focused on her schoolwork. until she was 17 when she began to skip school, training in secret in Wushu. Ended up becoming an Indonesian national champion and a world Wushu bronze medalist.
Sourcing the style starting to develop on the two. Priscilla seems to be counter-striking, waiting for Toto to go first, and Toto's the one initiating the strikes.
Antoniyar faking. And then side kick, that's a trademark of the Wushu striking, the side kick from Priscilla.
These styles blend perfectly together because of the counter-striking of Priscilla. You know, she usually, sometimes she's hesitant. She doesn't throw a lot of strikes because she's waiting for her opponent to go first. But Antoniyar Toto is perfectly okay with going first.
Bozhena Antoniyar, two-time Myanmar national boxing champion, competed in the 2013 Southeast Asian Games. Antoniyar actually began training around the same age in martial arts, boxing for Antoniyar at 16 years old. Wushu for Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol at 17 years old. Driving takedown, boom, straight back to the feet though for Antoniyar.
Big takedown from Priscilla, but Toto pops right back up to her feet, gets the body lock, presses her up against the wall. Let's see what Toto can do here.
Knee guard put on by Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol.
Priscilla's got that underhook, and she's got it jacked up pretty high on her left side. That might enable her to circle off. Beautiful outside creep of the leg to end up on top.
Bozhena Antoniyar has never won by submission. It would be a shock if she did so tonight. It is Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol. She's going to try and choke her! Have a look at this!
Antoniyar's been working with the Leone brothers out there in Bali MMA, so you know she's got a very good skill set when it comes to groundwork.
Antoniyar right in the back of Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol!
It's like that arm is working its way under the chin.
Now for that looks in the sold-out crowd here in Jakarta. They can't believe what they're seeing. Priscilla's in trouble!
Oh, and she was shaking her off. The hand went underneath the chin.
Priscilla's in big trouble!
Oh, in the excitement, I didn't hear the bell.
I tell you, it's so deafening in here, I didn't even hear the bell dragging. She was in trouble, Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol.
Look at this. Gets the leg, sweeps it out, went for the double leg, couldn't quite get it, but she decided to reap the leg, put her on her back, Toto pops right back up. But then watch this. Watch Toto reap the legs and put her on her back. And then she was able to take the back, sink in the choke, came ever so close to get hit, but Priscilla survived the round in the first 5 minutes. A lot of drama in that first five, Michael Spiller.
Remember what? More punching, okay? Remember boxing. Hey, very good round.
Just an inswell being applied to that hematoma above the left eye of Bozhena Antoniyar. What a sight it is inside the Astana Senayan in Jakarta, Indonesia. Second round of three. Both athletes had their opportunities in the opening stanza. We're watching live across the world in over 130 countries. Hope you're enjoying it. Southpaw stance on Priscilla. Priscilla's parents, who had aspirations of sending her to medical school or for a degree in IT. She used to practice in secret. And her parents eventually found out that she was good at Wushu and winning tournaments. They got right on board supporting their daughter. Thrilled now that she's become the face of female martial arts in Indonesia. Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol. 6-4, Bozhena Antoniyar 3-1. Let's see if Antoniyar can find an opening to get her hands off. Two-time Myanmar national boxing champion. holds the fastest knockout in ONE Women's history, 24 seconds against Choi Sin in February 2018. That was in her ONE debut. Shots go up for Indonesia around the Astana Senaya.
See him trying to trade leg kicks right now just to kind of get the range. As Priscilla flurries in, lands a two-punch combination and exits. Bozhena's going to have to be a little bit more aggressive here.
Priscilla, a less busy year than she had in 2018. 1-1 so far 2019, 5-1 in 2018 for the Indonesian. Short left hand upstairs there from Antoniyar. Backs up Priscilla. Priscilla on the outside, circling dangerously into the power side of Antoniyar.
That side kick keeps her distance, keeps her at range. It makes her think twice about entering into those boxing combinations. She is fully in and she is connecting. Priscilla does a beautiful job of striking off the back foot.
That kick down from Antoniyar. Antoniyar connects cleanly to the jaw of Priscilla. Priscilla is going to be hurt. Bozhena Antoniyar packs some power. Two knockouts in three wins. Using on back-to-back victories. Priscilla resets, tries to reach his side, kicks the lead knee.
Didn't really connect on the jab, but she followed up with that straight left hand. But that push kick is landing. Very effective at keeping her away.
Looking right hand there from Antoniyar. Under 2 minutes remaining, second round. Short lift to the inside, then gets out of dodge, does Antoniyar.
See, Priscilla's constantly circling to the right side of Antoniyar. She can time it right. She might be able to land that big right hand. She's looking for it. That push kick just gives her a lot of problems in creating distance.
Southpaw stance now for Antoniyar. And back to Orthodox. Priscilla. There may be stamped some authority in center circlers. Antoniyar has consistently pressed her to the outside, and she does so again. Priscilla would love to get Antoniyar on her back, have top position, rain down some ground and pound. Hope to sink a sub on the lady from Myanmar. Over a year since Priscilla's found the submission. Under a minute to go now, second round of three. This crowd running on their national superstar. Antoniyar fakes. Priscilla goes to her right. Overhand right there from Antoniyar. Inside kick to the midsection from Priscilla. Antoniyar resets. Myanmar went 1-1 now. One century show, a loss to Pintor, a win, a big win for Onlan Sun over Brandon Vera. And Bozhena Antoniyar follow on from Onlan's massive victory. Check it out on our Facebook page. It's got over 8 million views. It was epic. The kick there from Antoniyar.
Nice counter left hook off that leg kick.
Two down, one to go. It's for Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol, and Bozhena Antoniyar. And once again on that ONE Fantasy game on the ONE Super app, 57% of fans were tipping a victory for Priscilla Hertati, Lumban Gaol.
Pretty close right now. You can see the fantasy game was pretty close. This round was pretty close. Seeing that forward pressure, you're seeing the aggressiveness of Toto versus the counter striking of Priscilla. Oh man, it's gonna come down to this third round. I think it's pretty even going into this. Tough call. Toto is starting to land, but that push kick keeps her away, keeps the distance. Keeps her at Priscilla's range where she's able to land shots. She's also landing some inside leg kicks too. Very close first and second round.
Third and final round, Indonesia versus Myanmar. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol versus Bozhena Antoniyar. 5 minutes remains for one of these two athletes to stamp their authority to take this match. It would be the biggest win of Bozhena Antoniyar's career. It would be a hat-trick for Antoniyar, 3 wins in a row. Opens up with an early combination. Let's see if Priscilla can get her down, put her on her back. That's just the bit. We talk about the boxing of Antoniyar, but seeing Priscilla open up before with her hands, and she's no slouch in the boxing department.
Like this little skipping leg kick that Antoniyar's kind of thrown. She picks up her leg. It reminds me a lot of Muhammad Ayman.
This out of my division in one championship is absolutely stuck. Of course, the reigning queen, Angela Lee, triumphant in Tokyo with Zhong Jiman.
Really missing there on the combination exchange from Priscilla. Good head move by Toto.
You've got Mai Yamaguchi looking for another title shot. You've got Bean Yuen in the mix. You've got Stan Fairtex. Those two will meet in Manila.
Antoniyar gets the victory here. Where does that put her in this mix? I think she's possibly knocking on the door of a title shot.
No, Mitchell, not a matchmaker, but I'd like to see Antoniyar versus Mai Yamaguchi. I think it'd be very entertaining. Edges forward now. There's Antoniyar. Throws the overhand right. Goes body. Then goes head off the left hand.
Though that was beautiful. That second punch that she's landing with, she might miss the first, but she'll cut you on the second.
What does Priscilla need to do here, Dragon?
The problem is Priscilla waits. She's a counter striker. She waits for Antoniyar to come forward, and then she's able to counter. That's what she needs to do. She needs to go forward, putting Toto on her back. Now she's on top.
This is more like it from Priscilla. Top position. If she can posture up and start to work the ground and pound, she'll get on song, and the crowd will start to rally behind her again.
It's a good spot for Priscilla to be in, but she's got to do work here. You can see Toto's wrapping up her head, trying to keep it nice and tight. But she's not able to land the ground and pound, and the referee might be forced to stand him up.
Definitely charge of Indonesia again. Ring out in front of the sold-out of Sport Asinaya. Those down from Bozhena Antoniyar now opens it up. 2 minutes remaining. If Priscilla can posture up and work the hammer fist to the elbows, this crowd will go into a meltdown. But can she do it? You see how Bozhena Antoniyar is pulling her down, locking her down, controlling Priscilla's posture.
Good position for Priscilla to be in the last 90 seconds of this match. She's got to do a little bit more work here. The rounds were so close, you don't know how the judges are going to see it. She's got to do a little bit more on the ground and pound. And Antonia's got to get up. She cannot sit here and be complacent, just trying to hold the hand, waiting for a stand-up. She's got to let go. She's got to push off the hips. She's got to get her back up against that fence and start working her way up.
Jumping out of their seats here in Indonesia, watching on SCTV, and also in Myanmar, watching on Skynet.
Keeping Priscilla in a position to land ground and pound.
Here comes Priscilla with the elbow.
victory set Lumban Gaol up for the biggest opportunity of her career, a chance to show the world that she is a serious contender for the one women's atomweight world title.
Oh, yes, that's good night, Irene!
On the 6th of November, she faces second-ranked atomweight contender, Meng Bo. If Priscilla can overcome Meng Bo, she catapults herself to the top of the division, where she will either be within reach of a world title shot or earn her place in the one atomweight world grand prix. While Tati approaches a crossroads in her career, Saputra is making his way up the flyweight division. Now riding a three-fight win streak, Saputra's last bout was against Murugan Silvarajoo, where he shocked the world with a never-before-seen submission.
100% finishing rate for Saputra, 67% finishing rate for Silvarajoo. Indonesia versus Malaysia. Outside leg kick from Silvarajoo, who is the taller of the two, by some 7 centimeters. And he used that reach to keep the wrestler at bay, because once Saputra locks up with him and takes him down, it could be an early night for Silvarajoo. Already the aggressor meter high, Mitch, for Eka Roni.
Yeah, you can see Saputra's trying to land that right hand. He's getting very tight. I'm surprised he didn't attempt a takedown right there, because you can see that Silvarajoo was a little bit discombobulated, and that right hand just keeps coming. Saputra is starting to feel it. You can see him starting to get a lot more comfortable out there in the stand-up exchange.
Silvarajoo comes in off a hat-trick of wins that earns him a ticket to the big stage of one championship. Good right hands from Eka Roni. Saputra, another right hand, winging left hand from Eka Roni. Overhand elbow, the assault, the barrage, the onslaught from Eka Roni Saputra. He's got Silvarajoo on the outside. Now the Malaysian drifts off to his right and eats another solid right hand. Double leg now from Eka Roni Saputra. All one-way traffic so far. And there's nothing worse, Mitch, than traffic in Indonesia. And my word, Silvarajoo is finding that out right now.
I was just going to say that. I'm surprised Eko took him down actually this time, because he was having his way with him on the feet, letting go with those hands, and now he's in side control, starting to drop that ground and pound. Now he's going to look for a far arm Americana right there. Good job by Silvarajoo. He needs to get that underhook on that left side so he can start working his way onto his side. He's got to try to not stay flat. He's got to turn to his right side, create that space, and get moving. But that underhook on that left arm, if he can get underneath the arm of Eka Roni Saputra, that is going to enable him to turn onto his side and start to work his escapes. But right now, he is stuck in this position.
Eka Roni Saputra hunting for a first round finish. Mitch, he's going, oh, he's tapped out.
That's a shoulder lock with his leg. That's nasty.
The incredible submission put the flyweight division on notice. On the 6th of November, these two Indonesian superstars aim to show the world that Indonesians are ready to take over mixed martial arts. Saputra plans to add another spectacular win to his streak, while the stakes have never been higher for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol, who stands a chance to leapfrog to the very top of the one atomweight division.